Ciao ragazzi, my name is Cristiano Criminelli. I'm one of the founders of the Criminelli Fine Meat. You know, we make salami here in Salt Lake City, and at the tradition arriving from actually from my hometown in Biella. My family do this kind of job for a lot of generation. I think the first record we have is around the 14th century, so we talk about a little bit of time ago, but in Italy it's really common you take the job of your father and then you pass down the job to your son. So for a lot of generation you do the same job. And you know, when was my turn, I start to take care of all the aspect of the production of the salami. But I was ready to do something a little bit different. So I decided to come here in US, in Salt Lake City, to produce in salami in the same way I did in Italy. And a lot of people ask me, like, why Salt Lake City? Salt Lake City actually is an amazing place because the climate is very similar to my home region, the Piemont. So it's a very dry climate, and we can actually produce the salami in the artisanal way, actually in the real way, like we do in Italy. Okay, and now let's talk about the quality. I like to define our product with artisan quality. What means basically everything is made in a particular way, starting from the raw material, the way of fermenting, the way of aging. So raw material, very important, like especially from the meat. You know, the meat is 99% of the product is the meat. So we like to use just humanely raised pig. And I know sometimes it's fun when I talk with people because they tell me like what means. It means these pigs, they're happy. This is what means basically. They have a wonderful life. They're going to have good food. They have the ability to run and to go around and whenever they want to do. So they are going to have a happy life. Happy life of the pigs means wonderful meat. Second really important ingredient, spice. All organic. Why organic? Just because I know when they are organic, they are 100% spice. So if they tell you, okay, this one is 1 pound of pepper, is 1 pound of pepper, there's nothing else inside. We don't put any other chemical. The fermentation itself is totally natural. It's a process happen with the bacteria we introduce inside the salami. So the bacteria digest the sugar they find in the salami and they produce lactic acid and fermented the product. When you fermented the product, basically you make the product totally safe and you change the flavor and the texture. Very, very important. This is what means artisanal quality. And now let's talk a little bit about the product. The four products probably I like more. Starting with the prosciutto. Prosciutto, you know, is the king of the salumi in Italy. Prosciutto is wonderful in every time, in everywhere. If you need to choose something like to put with the prosciutto, I will stay with something like a Parmigiano Reggiano or Grana Padano. So Parmigiano Reggiano probably is the best. Strong cheese is pairing really well with the prosciutto. And then if you want also to put like some wine with the prosciutto, my personal opinion is sparkling white. Like a Prosecco, like a Franciacorta, is working so well. If you want to stay a little bit more like close to the area where the prosciutto is born and is made, you can use actually a Lambrusco. Very good too. Second one, the Varzi. Varzi is the salami. You know, if you go in Italy and you ask for salami without telling the specific name of the salami you want, they're going to give you the Varzi. Varzi is the salami you find inside the sandwich when Italians go to the stadium to see play soccer, you know. This is the real salami. And you know, it's a mild salami actually, so it's very versatile. I think you know, you can pair with a lot of different cheese, also mild cheese. You know, if you like goat cheese, you like mozzarella, this kind of like soft and not really powerful cheese. With the Varzi, probably they're going to work really well. It's wonderful with nuts, it's wonderful with olives. So let's say it's probably the best salami also for antipasto. For an antipasto plate is working really well. In terms of wine, in this area is the area of the Barbaresco, Barolo, Barbera, you know, the important red wine from the south of Piemont. So one of these three, you never go wrong. Then we have the tartufo. Tartufo actually is a truffle salami made with truffle, again from home region, Piemont. The flavor itself is really particular, intrigant. So I will tell you, I'm not going to pair with something really strong. I will stay again with something like not powerful. You know, a very fresh cheese, not aged. If you want to put something like a little bit different, you can maybe arrive into a Toma, so a 2-3 month age cheese, but probably not more, not more strong. And also with this one, is working really well with the red wine, the Barolo, Barbera e Barbaresco. But believe me, if you want to be a little bit more fancy, especially during the holiday season, a good glass of champagne with Tartufo is going to work really well, believe me. And the last one, Soppressa. Soppressa Veneta is a particular salami made all around in Italy. This one is particular because it's Veneta, is made in the Veneto region. It's a salami with a little bit of garlic and wine inside. Probably the perfect pairing for me for cheese will be or Asiago or Piave, you know, some cheese actually arriving from the same area with a strong flavor, because they need to contrast this very strong flavor of the Soppressa. If you want to pairing with a wine, I would be probably with the Cabernet or the Merlot, so a red important tannic wine, you know, something actually is going to help to emphasize the acidity of the salami. Okay, so we talk a little bit about my four favorite product, and I hope you like. And you know, feel free to reach me all the time you need by phone, by mail. I will be happy to talk with you guys, and I hope you're going to have a wonderful time. Ciao.